today.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi, everyone. Basil Chapman, Tiger Technician's Hour, Monday through Friday, noon till 1 p.m. Eastern Time, 877-927-6648. It's the beginning of the week, basically the beginning of the month. Let's just go through this as carefully as I can. We're looking at a Dow down 187. It is actually doing quite well, considering that the S&P is down only 7. But what we are looking at is that Boeing, let me just check this, Boeing is down over 7, and United Health, which is usually a leader, is leading down, is down 8, and Microsoft is down sharply. So, and Exxon's down sharply. So, and McDonald's is down sharply. So what we're looking at is a situation where in the relative strength of the markets today, we're looking at the Dow lagging. It's gone into an arch formation, made a beautiful little cup formation. You saw the rising wedge formation, rising narrowing wedge formation. That's not expanding, but narrowing. We broke under the red dashed line, and now we've got... the MACD is still good, and the moving averages are still good. So I haven't yet put even a sell signal on, even though it looks like it should be in a sell signal. I'm waiting a day or so. It might turn out that the sell signal coincides exactly with an upgrade to a sell mode. Haven't got there yet, still holding really well. When you consider what we've done to the upside and how little we've done to the downside here, probably be using up at this stage, you're using up more time than price. Look at the S&P. The S&P at this moment is down 9 at 28.21, had a high of 29.54, recovery high right on. I love this. Look at this. You didn't even have to care about the 200 orange, 200 period exponential moving average for months since the high that was made back in February. And then all of a sudden, you're coming right back. And boom, hits it exactly, pulls back. And now it is underneath the 14s, right on the 14, went under it and way below the 9. So the MACD is still good. It needs to be closing down below today's low to actually cross negative. And the stochastics at 71% on balance volume is not very good. So let me tell you what I'm looking at here. I'm going to go back to the Dow because I want to give you parameters for the week that I'm looking at. On the week, the Dow is at 23,532, had a low in the 23,360s. I'm looking at this and I'm saying, if there is a close on a daily basis below 23,520, 23,480, just in that area, a close below it, it says there's a real good chance that we're going to try to get down to the 22,941 low, and that was of April the 21st. If we can hold, and by the end of the day, and what I say to subscribers, and also posted in the den for my email, this is what I do for my subscribers every market day. Let me just get there if I can. Oops, wrong one. Let me get here. There we go. So what we're looking at is in my e-mini chart. I think this is it. Let's hope it is. No, it's not. Let's hope this is it. No, it's not. Let's hope this is it. Yep, it is. So in my e-mini chart, what I said was, went right up into the 200 period exponential moving average. It's pulled back. It is underneath the rising narrowing wedge. The weekly chart is probably going to make a leg B today because I can't see anything that's going to take it above the 29.65 round number high that made the peak in the daily and leg B in the weekly. The MACD is just turning down, but it's still holding okay. But I'm suspecting that we've got an arch formation. How and where we land up testing in the arch formation is going to be very important. But look at the 120-minute chart. Look at this beautiful arch formation. Look what I drew in. Actually, let me go to the live chart because this is so interesting. Look, ESM20. Let me just go to the 120-minute chart if I can get to it right now. There we go. There it is. Have a look at this. Just tell me if chart patterns just aren't totally fascinating. Look at this. Yep, there we go. So 27.55 was the low around about the 24th of April. It had a spectacular run, and it had what I called a one-to-one extension to the upside. Actually, I needed to correct this. The most conservative thing would have been there and then there. So we just went a little bit below 2965. If it was an exact measurement, it would have gone to 2971. I'd say 6 points is pretty good. You got your peak D. Remember the Chapman wave, we're always looking for a peak D, because at a peak D, that's where other things can happen. And let me just show you this other thing, because this is a nice little lesson here in Chapman wave methodology. And what are we looking at? From the lowest, most identify a low bar, you count each successively higher peak. At peak D, other things can happen. It can go up in a different waveform. It can extend with a Chapman wave instant restart that can take you all the way to a brand new A, B, C, D, four higher peaks. Or it can start a much deeper decline. Look at this. On the left, you can see there's a 120-minute E-mini 28.36.75 peak D. Look, it dropped all the way to 27.55. So these are very important. That's the one thing. And the other is, it's just look, I love to look at patterns, straight line move up or down. That's one. Two is an arch. Three is a cup. And you can get a mix of the H pattern where it comes down sharply, makes an arch. Red, because if it takes out the left side low, it can go quite a bit lower. And green, because if it takes out the high, the inverse Y, it can go quite a bit higher. So I just try to keep things as simple as possible. I've got tons of techniques, but this is the simplicity of it. And Bob, I'll get to that, and I'll also get to Peaky's question in a moment. Now look what's happened. You've taken eight bars, 120 bars from the low of 27.71. And what I wanted to show you was the fascination with, look, there's a left side, right side price time match that I had at 28.12.75 all day Friday. We were talking about it, and we went right there. We went to it, and then we tried to bounce overnight on Sunday night, gap, huge gap down, and it goes to 27.71. Wait a minute, 27.71? That's this little doji candle here, the third candle after the 27.55 low on the 24th. So, and I had already drawn this in on Friday. I drew it in here. I chose a particular candle that I thought was important to the right side match. And look, it came to the exact bar. I had no idea. Look, the exact bar, 2771 low. So this is a retracement to the upside. And it's really important. But so far, it's taken so much time without any velocity to the upside. No, definitely had velocity off the low of 27.71 to 28.14. And then it just got stuck. Now the velocity has to turn into momentum. In other words, we've had the stochastic turn up, which is like your initial first gear. It's like the torque. But then you want the MACD to take over with the higher gears. And it's just not doing it. It's kind of pathetic. The high today is 28.17.75. A little earlier on, it was 28.14.50. It's got a long way to go. It's got to turn this black line, the 40-period moving average of about 28.13. Needs to turn this whole area between the pink and the black into a springboard. You want to see 28.22 to 28.25 by the end of the day. And that'll say, hey, nice rebound to go into Tuesday afternoon, maybe Wednesday, and then perhaps we start heading down again. All right, that's it with some of the technicals. I'll go through all the rest of it as soon as we get back. I'll be back in a moment. Dow's down 204. S&P is down only 10. I'll be right back.
If you're not currently using the TAS profile scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS profile scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. TFNN is launching an open house for our Tiger's Den. For a limited time, you can get a 30-day free trial to the Tiger's Den. Just enter promo code OPEN at checkout and pay nothing for 30 days while you try out your Tiger's Den membership as part of our open house. With market volatility at an all-time high and people all over the world working from home if possible, TFNN is hosting an open house in our Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is an interactive chat room that runs all day where other Tigers and Tigresses discuss trading ideas with the hosts and members, along with charts and current market news, as well as live access to the charts the hosts use during their programs. Join us for the Tiger's Den Open House. Begin your den membership today by just entering OPEN at checkout and pay nothing while you try things out for 30 days. For all the details and to start your den membership today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the TFNN Tiger's Den Open House taking place now. Sign up today.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Okay, so, ton of questions came in. Let me just wrap this up quickly. So we've got the QQQs, 213.77, up $1.02, sitting nicely. This is, considering what it did to the upside, these 2 days are quite impressive, actually. And that's with Microsoft. I've got a question about Microsoft. I'll get to it in a moment. Microsoft is down quite a bit. All right, so I'll get to that. In the meantime, I'm just saying to you, if you see the Qs trading underneath 209, let's make it 208.50, closing under 208.50, there's a good chance we're going to test the 206s, and that's going to be quite important in the very short term. More important is intermediate term in the next week or so. Any close under 201 is the 200 period moving average. Any close below 201, that's going to be takes 11 points. I don't know how what's going to do that. But any close under there starts to say to me, now you've got to look at this market very differently. At this point, I just think this is a high-level consolidation all the way around. IWM is trading down 73 cents at 124. Now it's lagging again. You remember, what was the rule of the ChapmanWave stalk leg formation? You remember, I have all these, this myriad set of technical tools that I've developed over the decades. Remember, stalk leg, body, neck, and I said, what happens? It should come back and retest 124.88, the neck, the body high, and then we'll see what happens, because what happens in a stalk leg formation, when it completes its down move, it often has a really strong rally, and then you're on your own. You have to use other techniques. So far, we'll see how the 120, say 124.44, a close under 123.33, somewhere around there, and that would be quite negative. All right, let's just do this quickly. Gold is trading up at 12. It's in this trading range, making the H pattern. It's trying to form a cup formation. I still think gold is in play, although for my subscribers, we do not have a gold stock. I'm waiting for certain conditions to be met where I'd like to buy gold for the next big phase on the upside, having missed it to the downside. I mean, having missed this last big rally. We're in so many different positions. I just didn't feel I needed it right now. So silver also is trading quite nicely. It's up. Oh, it was up. Now it's down. It's down 0.06 at 1487. Stuck in this range. I see quite nicely. I mean, just when I was looking at it earlier, but it's stuck in the range. And if you look at the dollar, this is a really nice move up 44 ticks, I should say, to 99.52, but just stuck in the range. They're all stuck in the range right now, like the TLT, stuck in a range. Look at that, 167.41. I just showed subscribers my my three-panel chart, the three yields. That's the TYX. Let me just show you this quickly, and then I can get that out of the way because I want to start off the week with all this, and then I'm going to go to the ton of calls, questions that I've got. There we go. This is mirror on the wall. There it is. Let me just quickly check. No questions there. Okay, good. So I've got emails and texts and then questions. So what we're looking at here is the three yields of white is the TYX 30-year. They will be coming in a second, I hope. Hey, what's going on? Uh-oh. They are. The white is the TYX 30-year. T-bond yield, the T-note yield is the brown right there, and the the cyan is trading right there, the low one. And you can see they spread out quite distantly, but they are stuck in a range, in the lower range. If you look at the global wood iShares, global timber and forestry ETF, made a leg B, probably a peak B this week. This is important. It had a fabulous bounce. It's only a bounce. And the same thing with HEX, the housing, Philadelphia housing sector index. It's down 2.87. Today. It's just kind of stuck. So all of these, I think, are range bound. And the reason why I'm saying that is because I think the Fed is totally concerned with not yields, but they're totally concerned with getting the money out. They've got to get money out. They've got to keep things going as long as possible. All right, here come the questions. Very first question I had was, I wrote it down, didn't I? FLDM, deflator mouse. FLDM is, this is what? Fluidigm. Corporation trading at $3.71, up 35 cents. Really nice move. Made a leg D on Friday, hit the 200 period moving average. A good eye, Peaky. I like this. I think it's digesting its gains. We had another fluid stock, and I can't remember what it was offhand, but I think that this is stuck right now between the 445 area and the 256. That's a huge range. But you asked me about it. I like it if you're long. I'm just going to say, stay long. If you aren't in it and you want to know what to do, it's really tough because it has nothing, and then it has a big spike, and then it does nothing. Look at the monthly chart. But I like the fact that it's gone to leg D, leg B in the weekly. Here's my suggestion. Because it's you, anyone else I wouldn't say this to, but I know that you are prepared to start a position looking out longer term. I like it. I think it's in the right area. I'm going to say to you, 370, it's not my ideal price. But I'm not going to fuss over a few cents because I think it does target, as far as I can see, the $5 area of the weekly, the monthly 200 period moving average. What's the matter with me? With the 14 period exponential moving average in the monthly chart. And it might not get there today, but I think it does target that. I'm going to suggest, the 370 level. I'm not going to fuss over 10 cents. I'm going to say start your engines. That's all. Just start it. If you haven't got it, just start your engine. And then we'll see what happens. And then just remind me in 3 days' time, because I think at 333 to 322-ish, today's low is 276. How it's holding there after maybe dipping a little bit and coming back, or going up and coming back, that's kind of the area. In fact, let me make it 293 to 323. That's the area that I'd be looking at to see whether to add or not. So, yes, in your case. Now, next question I had was, did I write it down or did I not? Let me just go to this right here. I keep hitting the wrong mouse. There you are. Kind of four different mice. There we go. Noontime, that's my show. And then I had the questions coming in. I did that. Microsoft. So, Bob. Microsoft has been an absolute stellar performer, one of the very best in the Dow. is trading at $177.56, $12 off its all-time high, having gone from 190 down to the 132-ish area, come all the way back to 189 round number high, and now it's just kind of tootling along. And that round number high was tested 3 days ago at 180 open, and 100 and, why is this different? That there, oh, 180, I couldn't understand why it said 189. 180 round number high. Double tops 3 days ago to 180, and it's trying to come back again. It's turned the arch formation into a lowercase cup formation. Oh, this is such good action. Wow. This is telling us that there's a coronavirus in the throughout the country. This is incredible. Wow, it looks good. I'll be back. We'll talk about Microsoft, and then I got a whole bunch of other questions. CYDY. CYDY. Boeing. Oh.
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the opening call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The opening call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the opening call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that we'll even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. We're back. So what we're looking at is Microsoft's holding really well. I like it very. If you're in Microsoft, all I can say is depends where you got in. If you got in quite a bit lower, all I would do is take a trading position. That's all. I'd use that trading position, and I'd say, you know what? In the 177 area, 3 points off the recovery high, but 10 points off the 13 points actually off the all-time high, I'm prepared to raise a stop on a small trading position. And if I get taken out, I'll try to put that back. And the place I would put it back is in the bottom of this candle right here. And that could be early, because if it does come down to this, it's probably going to hit the 50-period moving average, which is right now at 166, 10 points, 11 points lower. So it would be the low of somewhere in the low of the candle of the 21st of April, which had a high of 173.67 and a low of 166.11. So somewhere in there, I'd start to look, and just give me a yell. We'll look at it again together, because I think this H pattern is going to make an arch and then make another cup formation, W. It's like a double U. W means double, two U formations next to one another, a double U. Am I seeing it? No, I'm not. So I am. I'll look at it right now. So I like it very much. I probably wouldn't do anything right now. But if it starts to pull back a little bit from 177 to 176.10, I say, you know what, if you're a little nervous, take something off, but that you want to put back. I wouldn't short it. I just don't think at this point it's worth a short of one of the best stocks there is. Got it. Mark in Fort Collins. Hi, Mark. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm well. Thank you.
I want you to look at the IYF.
Okay. This is the iShares of the U.S. Financial ETF. I'm just going to put in the notation right now. It's gone to a C, peak A, peak B, and it just barely goes to a C. It's under the 50-period moving average, under the 9, it's under the 14. Yes, what's the question?
So whether the I'm thinking of playing the FAS again on the idea that this might make a peak D. What do you think?
Yes. So if you look at, keep your eye on the left, folks. This is the IYF trading at 102.08, down $1.25. Keep the pattern in mind and look at this. And here is the, this is the XLF, which is the S&P Select Financial Spider, slightly different format, but actually pretty much the same, except it did not. It was weaker. The money center banks were weaker because they had a couple of quite weak stocks in that sector. 23.66 was the high in the ninth. This one went to 23.66 for a double top U, a cup formation like a U, and now it's pulling back. And my rule of thumb with the pullback of a cup formation, if it takes out one third to one half of the left side lip to the bottom trough, be careful because it could retest the bottom. If it takes out the bottom, it could be a one to the downside. So now let me go to the IYF because it's slightly better. The mix is a little bit better there, but it's pretty much the same thing, except that the MACD is stronger. So I think that there are better opportunities with less risk, because this is in many ways, if you look at the monthly chart, look at the move of the IYF goes from 143.69. The very next month, I mean, in 2 months, it goes down to 81. So 81 from 143, I would say that's quite a drop. And as a result, the rebound and the monthly candle is good, but it's not. It isn't exciting. It would have been much better if the last two days of April and the first day of May were up in the higher range, and today was just a minor pullback. So this is saying to me, be a little careful, because I'm more favoring in pattern recognition the arch formation than I am some kind of higher highs and higher lows, because the depth of the decline over the last 2 days is just a little too deep. So this is tough for me, because I think we're in a consolidation, and I'm anticipating that we've got 2 days of running attempts today, going into tomorrow afternoon, maybe even Wednesday morning. And then by Wednesday afternoon, I wouldn't be surprised if we're coming back again. So I'm just going to recommend, if you're asking my opinion, Mark, I think this is the one time I'm just going to say to you, yes, I think there could be a D, but the pattern suggesting that there is not enough strength. There might not be enough weakness to really tank it, but there isn't enough strength to go much higher right at this moment. That's all.
Yeah, see, if you look at the FAS, it only formed a B, and it didn't quite get to a C. It just missed it. So that's what I was just kind of, but I was trying to play that.
Yeah, to say, so you've got in the FAS, you've got the XLF pattern there. So yeah. I'm just going to say that you asked my opinion. My opinion is probably there are better trades at this point, but I am going to say to you, later in the week, Wednesday or Thursday, give me a call. I want to look at it then. That's where we might get something because it's holding well. So thank you for calling.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Pleasure. My pleasure. So George wants to know about CY. First it goes Eddie. SWKS to SWKS coming out this afternoon. This is Skywork Solutions. Comes out for the earnings. It made a peak D. So what's the question? Hi, Basil. Can you look at SWKS earnings today? Did it restart all the way to a second D off the second bottom in the daily? Yes. So hey, Eddie, you're really getting good in the Chapman Wave. Look, it goes to peak D. That's the objective in the Chapman Wave. Then it pulls back a little sharper than it should have. So the next time it started, the MACD never even gave up. It never crossed negative. It still hasn't crossed negative. It's still looking. If you had to ask me right now, SWKS, Skywork Solutions, and you didn't tell me that earnings were coming out this afternoon, what would I do? I would say, this is a much nicer monthly candle, you see, to last month's, as I was talking to Mark about. So this is saying to me that the weekly chart still shows strength. It has 9-period moving average support at 95.35. It's trading at 98.50, just down 33 cents right now. This one has held. It's above the 200-period moving average of 95.80. Now, if you didn't tell me that earnings were coming out this evening, I would have said to you, I can see maybe 3 to 5 more sessions of consolidation. And if by Friday or Monday, this coming Friday, and by Monday, Skywork Solutions has not closed. It can slide under it, but it hasn't closed below 94.50. But it's held that all the way into Friday on a closing basis. I would have said to you, this is going to be one of those that comes back really quickly when there's a stronger rally in the market. But it's got earnings tonight. So I'm answering your question. You've done a great job, Eddie. Yes, it is a peak D. If this starts to pull back, and tonight, it's what the conference call is. It's not what the initial reception is. If after 4:30 this afternoon, going into tomorrow at tomorrow's opening at 9:30, Skywork Solution is managing to hold above a +3, meaning that everything looked quite good and the outlook is quite good, I would suggest to you that it's trying to form a base and that over May, the whole of May, there's a good chance that it's going to hold nicely above the 200-period moving average of 87. And if it doesn't even get to 92 area all of May, that's going to be one of those that leads the market out. If it closes down 5 points by tomorrow evening, I'm just saying to you, this is saying that even the best of the best are going under a lot of pressure. Hope that answers your question. I'll be back in a moment. Oh, we've got a bunch of questions still to answer. I'll be right back. Basil Chapman, Tiger Ignitions Hour. Dow is down now 207.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190. The gold market has taken off topside in a large way in 2020. If you want to take advantage of this sector, now is the time to subscribe to my gold report. The gold report took profits in 4 of its equities in the gold portfolio in the first week of January for a combined profit of 99.2%, with 2 positions left in the portfolio that have a profit of 67.5% as of January 7th. The gold report is a comprehensive look at the metal sector as well as the markets that move gold, which is the currency and bond markets. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, I publish the gold report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up now by visiting TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the next great gold trade. Sign up today.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Hi, folks. So let me just type this in here. You've got Cytodyn. I believe that should be a DIN, D-Y-N. Why is the C-Y, Cy, and the D-Y is a DIN? Because it should have an E and then it'll be dine. Anyway, that's their problem. Cytodyn, enhancing the lives of patients through target-specific medicine, developing biotechnology company focused on developing innovative treatment for multiple therapeutic indications. Okay, so it's trading right now at 2.77. And the question is from George in Tampa, what would be a good entry point for CYDY for a long position? Thanks for all the help you give us, George. So, George, you know, this has already gone to a leg E, probably a peak E this week if there's no new high above 3.878 or something? 3.84. And it's trading at 2.78 up minus 0.4. And it's a pink sheet paper because it's got four digits after the 2.7800. So you've got to almost book an appointment for this. Let me see the volume. Oh, no, big volume. Yeah, big volume. 8 million, 10 million. Good. Okay. So what I'm going to do is say this. It's got a cyclicality to it and it's making higher highs and higher lows. This last move, I'm calling it a peak C. I'm not sure that this has got that same rhythm that it will go to a D, but I'm going to give it a couple of days. So all I'm going to say, if you aren't in it, but you're looking at a more intermediate term type position because you've done your homework and you like it, the monthly is only in B, it can move on a percentage basis. Look, today it's down 13%, but it's only down 0.42 cents. So I'm just going to say to you, my eye says in the rhythm of the movements, and you remember now I'm looking at it rhythmically, I'm not looking at it just pattern-wise, but I'm looking at the way it arches up and explodes to the upside. It's either a buy right here at 2.77 because in the next day it's going to fill the gap and it's going to try to get to 3.28 into the middle of Friday's bar, or you just have to wait. So here's what I'm going to say to you. If you've done your homework, and I suspect that's the only reason why you've asked me the question. Let's see, question. Yeah. I'm just going to suggest to you, look, start a little nibble. This is something you have to put in the drawer. This is like an option and just a long holding option. That's all you can think of it, like a call option. And I'm at 2.78. I'm just going to say nibble here. This is not ideal. Well, ideal would be not to get even close to the low of 2.00 on the 15th, but to get to the low of the candle of the 22nd, which is 2.41. Well, you say 30 cents, what's the big deal? It's 11%. I mean, it is a big deal. So I'm just going to say, just start a little position here to give you a feel for how it acts and reacts throughout the day, regardless of what the market is doing. How does it independently work? Then the next thing I'm going to say to you is, if it starts to rally from here, you're in a position, not the best position to be in, because you've only just started it and now it's already moving. Then we'll have to look to see where to add. So by Wednesday, I'd say, let's look at it again. But nibble here at 2.77. But ideally, it doesn't have to be of the low of the day of 2.53. Somewhere between 2.55 and 2.46, I'm suspecting, is probably the best entry point. But it has to be time-wise, either today or tomorrow. If it doesn't do that but just goes sideways, then I have to have a whole completely different plan, because it's lost its momentum to the upside. Hey, but it's lost its momentum to the downside. The MACD's turned down, stochastic's turned down. It's below the, I should actually, if there was a D, I would have probably put a down arrow. So I'm saying, if you're looking out, the weekly chart is saying it's still pretty darn good. The daily chart says it's a little toppy. Try to get a better entry point. And let me know what you do, but I'll look at it again in a few days if you remind me. Next question I had was Boeing. Boeing was down on a loss. Looked, it's still down. It's down 5 at 127. Remember the rectangle formations? I drew a bunch of them. So it's just taken out this particular one right here. No, it hasn't taken it out yet. It's close to taking it out. And if it does take the low out, let me just move this. There you go. If it does take out the low of, if it closes under 123.90, then the next level of support is the one that I drew in over here. And that is right there. And that is this low of 120.02. Let's call it 120. If it takes it, if it closes under one, I'm going to make it 123. If it closes under 123, 120 becomes the next level of support in Bowie. He's just stuck in a range. Next question I had was, would I look at, where did it go? Would I look at VIXI? So this is going to be VXX. Let's do that for the moment. It's trading down 7 cents at 41.12. The VIX itself is trading at 37.74, up 55 cents. I have to tell you something, that the action of the volatility index, when I did my work over the, I sent out charts over the weekend, I did a lot of work just looking to say, where could I be wrong? Not where could you be right. It's always great. When you're right, you don't have to do very much work. Where could I be wrong? And I could be wrong in misjudging the comeback of the 25, 30, 35 million people out of work by thinking that it is not just people that are necessarily out of work, but they've applied under the auspices of out of work. But in fact, they have jobs to go back to. If everything comes back again, they have it. And that'll be a percentage of the 30 million, which I'm suspecting is about 5 to 9 million people will immediately fall off as soon as businesses start coming back. And then some are going to stick and stay because they're probably getting paid more now than they got before. And others are just, it's a horrible, horrible situation. I mean, you work all your life, you've built it for family, business, or whatever it is. And a virus comes along and everybody's, the whole country just gets shaken out. That's what I might be misjudging. But there is a chance, and you'll see it, when those myriad companies, I know firsthand of people, who are actively involved in the coronavirus, in the companies, or have knowledge of people in the companies that are going straight towards trying to find some kind of an antidote to the virus. And it is literally not in the dozens or the hundreds, it is way over 200-300 companies. When they come out with something, it's going to turn it, hopefully, it's just going to turn this thing into all the varieties of the virus are going to be hammered away, I mean, to get rid of it. But the other thing is also, when you're looking at, it's not just looking at the virus, it's looking at the way the states come back, the way the bigger states are going to be slow to come back, but there's going to be a lot of people in the states. They're going to say, in my field of work, I can be anywhere. I could be very healthy in my little cocoon. Why can't I go back? So that's what's going to be. I think we might. There's a chance we come back a little quicker in some areas than even people in their wildest dreams could imagine. And that's the thing that's going to have to carry the weak spots. It's very complex. Next question I had. So that was that. That was that. That was that. Question. UAL. URL is United Airlines. Yeah, I don't like these patterns. These H patterns, they go to an M pattern. I don't like them at all. Then I had a question in the chat. I'll get to the questions that I'm missing here. There are quite a bunch. Did I finish my thought on the VIX? Yeah, the VIX is finally starting to come down, and that's really important. That's what I wanted to say. Sorry, it was a little bit circuitous. I'll be right back.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get the competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionics, oil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated fulvic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. This is Steve Rhodes. Stay tuned for another great hour of the Trader's Edge heard here at TFNN.com.
I said DraftKings, DKNG. I had a question about that. Yeah, DKNG. It should try to retest the high that was made is 21.30 up $1.18. The high that was made, DraftKings, was 22.50 was the high on the 27th. I think it's stuck in this range. It might go a little a tad above it, but just for now, I think it's acting very well. It's a kind of a leader in this market downturn. This is on the upside. So this is acting well, and I think it's going to test it. If it can close above 22.80, I think that'll be very good because it helps the weekly and the monthly charts. Very good. Keep your eye on this. Oh, you have it? That's good. I like it. Next question was Newmont Mining, NEM, Newmont Mining. This is a pattern that I like. This is the one that I discussed. This is the Chapman Falling Axe formation. Let me just say I like this together with gold, G-O-L-D, which is right here. What was the question? Hi, Basil. I enjoy listening to your show. I have a position in gold. Was wondering if there is some some action. Is it possible to cover this during the show? Thanks, Sheriff. Okay, so this is made of PE, and it's got the ChapmanWave falling X formation. Should go one-to-one to the upside at 6271. I like it. I like the monthly. I like the weekly. I definitely like it in the fact that it's tried to test the 57s. It's held above that. I suspect on a worst-case basis that the GOLD, which is Barrick Gold, is also breaking out. That if they do digest these really big gains, it's more going to be a sideways move. This has tremendous, it's a 27.24, has really strong support in the 24s. And what we're looking at, the Newmont Mining question in the den, has a lot of support. It's at 50, it's at 62.73, has a lot of support in the 55s. So if you're looking at that, on a longer-term basis, great. So just let me show you something in ChapmanWave methodology. This is what people in my webinar did. That was a webinar that was two Wednesdays ago. Remember, peak D is the most important thing. When you get to D, look at this one-minute chart, peak D right there. Look at that sharp pullback. Five-minute chart, peak D. 10-minute chart, double top at peak D. Those Ds are absolutely incredible. And that's what we look at from ChapmanWave methodology. We're still in our long positions. We didn't add any. We're actually trying to add one. I forgot completely today to put the one I mentioned, and we would have got it, and it's up nicely. We'll do it tomorrow. Don't worry. Have a great day. Check out my opening call, my daily newsletter. Stay tuned for Steve.